A question will be given with dilution. What is dilution? Addition of water to a solution is called dilution. You know, on dilution, molarity of a solution decreases. Why? On dilution, why molarity decreases? Because in the standard formula, if you see in the standard formula, molarity and volume are inversely proportional. That means volume is in the denominator. That's why molarity, volume inversely. If volume is increased, molarity decreases. On dilution, volume increases. That's why molarity decreases. How to find out the molarity of a diluted solution? So for that, there is a formula M1V1 is equal to M2V2. Here M1V1 means these are the terms before dilution. These are the terms after dilution. That means molarity of solution before dilution, volume of solution before, after dilution molarity, after dilution volume. So based on this also some problems there are. How? Initially there is 1 molar solution, 100 ml. Initially 1 molar, 100 ml solution. If it is diluted to 1 liter, then what is the molarity of the resulting solution? That is the question. 100 ml of 1 molar solution is diluted to 1 liter. Then what is its molarity? So use this formula. M1 means before dilution molarity 1. Volume V1 means 100. That side, molarity we don't know after dilution. And volume is 1 liter. Here already I have taken molarity volume in milliliters. That's why there should be V2 also in milliliters. 1 liter means 1000 ml. Now M2 is equal to this 100 by 1000. That means 1 by 10. That means 0.1. So on dilution, see, in 100 ml solution, molarity of solution is 1 molar. But in 1000 ml, it is 0.1. That means molarity of a solution always decreases on dilution. Next, there is a direct formula to find out volume of water added during the dilution process. So how much volume of water is added? So for that, volume of water added is equal to V2 minus V1. This is the formula, V2 minus V1. So we can also calculate using another formula, that is M1 minus M2 into V1 by M2. This formula also we can use. Or M1 minus M2 into V2 by M1. V2 by M1. Using any of these three, we can calculate volume of water added. So this is a dilution concept for molarity. Next, if two solutions of similar solutes are mixed, how to find out the molarity of the resulting solution? See, for that, if two solutions of same or similar solute are mixed, then the molarity of resulting solution is equal to M1 V1 plus. Let's see a problem on this formula. There are two solutes, HCl and HNO3. This HCl is given 1 molar, volume 100 ml. This HNO3 is given 2 molar, volume 50 ml. If these two solutions are mixed, then what is the molarity of resulting solution? So if that type of question is asked, then use this formula directly. Here, take one terms for HCl and two terms for HNO3. Then resulting solution molarity is equal to M1 V1. That means 1 into 100 M1 V1 plus M2 V2, that means 2 into 50 by V1 plus V2, that means 100 plus 50. Its value is 100 plus 100, 200 by here 150. So, in that way we can find out the molarity of a solution which is formed by mixing two similar or same solutes. What is the molarity if two different solutes which are reacting are given? Then we use a different formula. So, what is that formula? Next, if two solutions of reacting solutes are given, then how to find out the molarity of the resulting solution? So, for that use this formula, M is equal to M1 V1 is by N1 is equal to M2 V2 by N2. This is the formula we use. Here take one terms for one solute, two terms for another solute. See how a problem is asked on this. Here HCl one side, HNaOH another side. Because these two are reacting, it is an acid, it is a base. So, there occurs a reaction between them, neutralization. Let this HCl molarity some 1 molar. Similarly, 50 ml solution is added. Here it is 2 molar and it is some 50 ml solution is added. Now, 1 molar 50 ml HCl solution, 2 molar 50 ml NaO solution are added. What is the molarity of the resulting solution? That means here first we find out which strength is more. Here what are N1 and N2? N1 and N2 are, these are not number of moles, these are the coefficients in the balanced equation. So first let us write a balanced equation between these two. HCl plus NaOH gives rise to NaCl plus water. This is the balanced equation. In this balanced equation, what is the coefficient of HCl? Nothing. Nothing means here coefficient is 1. Here also coefficient is 1. That means N1 is 1, N2 is 1. Substitute the values. So here one of any these four terms will be missing. Suppose this term is not given. We have to find out this term. How to calculate? Substitute in that. So here 1 into molarity 1 into 50 by number of molecules in the balanced equation 1, that side M2, 2 into volume, we don't know that, by its coefficient in the balanced equation 1. So here 50 is equal to 2 V2, that means V2 is equal to 25 ml. So 25 ml of NaOH is required to completely neutralize the 50 ml of 1 molar solution. So, this is the formula we use for reacting solutes. So, this is all about molarity concept.